Which one do you think looks more impressive and professional? First, let's take a look at the game state before using .win. And then, let's take a look at its state after adding animations to the UI objects using .win. In this Unity tutorial, we will make an example of how to animate UI objects using .win. Initially, I had planned to make this example using LintWin. Then, I realized that .win is more preferred than LintWin. Anyway, I first made slight changes to the UI design, and I added the levels menu we previously created to the game. You can check out these videos for detailed information about the levels menu. Hello dear friends, welcome to Rob Games. If you wish, let's start with the .win installation. Open the Unity Asset Store website. Search .win. Here, you will see two different versions of .win. The free version is enough for us. Click on Add to my Assets. Then go back to Unity, open Package Manager. You can see the .win package under my assets. Click on the import button. The import process will take a few seconds. Then a new window will open. Click on the button and click on the setup button. Wait a few seconds at this stage. Here you can remove models that you will not use. Then click on the apply button and wait for the installation to complete. If you wish, you can later access the .win panel from the tools bar. After the installation is complete, you can see the .win folder in the project panel. I opened the level 1 scene and started the game. As you can see, when I press the pause button, the pause panel suddenly opens. And when I press the resume button, it suddenly disappears. Let's take a quick look at the pause menu. As you can see, there is a pause button here, and when we press it, the pause menu object becomes active. The pause menu consists of a dark panel, a pause panel, and buttons. I added a click event to the buttons using the pause menu script located in the pause menu object. Let's take a quick look at the pause menu script. Pressing the pause button activates the pause menu and time stops. Pressing the resume button deactivates the pause menu and time continues. So, how do we make the opening of the pause menu more impressive? I will move the pause panel off screen. So, I'm gonna change the Y position of the pause panel's rect transform. When the player presses the pause button, I will move the pause panel on screen. And when the player presses the resume button, I will move the pause panel off screen again. Namely, when the player presses the pause button, we will adjust the y-axis value of the rect transform for the pause panel to 0. And when the player presses the resume button, we will set it to 750. We will make this change smooth and animated using .win. Let's see how to use .win for UI animation. Go back to the pause menu script. I will create two new functions named pause panel intro and pause panel outro. When the pause button is pressed, I will call the pause panel intro function. And when the resume button is pressed, I will call the pause panel outro function. We have to add the tuning library to use .win. I will create a rect transform variable to control the pause panel's position. And I have created the other variables I need. To use .win, we start by specifying the do key and then we choose the method we wanna use. I wanna change the Y position of the pause panel. First, we specify the target Y position. Then, we determine the time it takes to reach this target. I will copy this method and change the target position. Save the script and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the pause panel object to this slot. Set the variables. Top post y is the position value when the pause panel is off screen. Middle post y is the position value of the pause panel when it's on the screen. I will set the default position of the pause panel to top post y and set the twin duration. I will disable the pause menu by default. Okay, start the game. When I press the pause button, the pause menu became active. But the pause panel didn't move to the middle of the screen. The reason for this is that since we stopped time, the animation movement also stopped. Let's disable time stopping and start the game again. As you can see, the pause panel animation worked, but the game continues. Let's solve this problem quickly. We can make the animation independent of time with the setUpdate method. As you can see, the game stopped, but the animation moved. When I press the resume button, the pause panel suddenly closes without any animation movement. Because we disabled object without waiting for the animation to end. I will use asynchronous programming to solve the problem. So I will make a few minor changes to the function. We must use the async wait for completion method to make .win animations asynchronous. In this case, after the .win animation is completed, the pause menu object will have setActive set to false. Save and go back to Unity. As you can see, when I press the resume button, the animation is completed first and then the object becomes disabled. You can change the twin duration as you want. As you can see, when the pause menu is open, the background suddenly darkens. Let's improve the opening animation of the pause menu a little more. We can smooth the transition into darkens. So, I'm gonna add a canvas group component to the dark panel. And I will change the alpha value of the component using .win. Create a new variable for the canvas group component. We'll use the doFade function of the .win to control the alpha value. Copy this code and change the end value to 0. Set the alpha value to 0 by default. Drag and drop the dark panel object to this slot. Start the game. As you can see, we now have a soft fade. I want the timer and pause button to smoothly go off screen when the pause menu opens. First, we need to determine the position values. In this video, we provide a simple example using .win. We will explore more examples in future videos. I will copy and paste it. Okay, save and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the timer and pause button to their slot. Start the game. Nice, looks cool. Let's add SFX to make the UI animation more impressive. I added a pause panel whoosh sound effect to the project. Let's quickly take a look at the audio manager system. My audio manager object is like this. And the audio manager script is like this. I access the audio manager script from wherever I wanna play sound effects. You can discover detailed videos on the channel that explain how to incorporate sound and music into any game. Thanks for watching. See you in the next Unity tutorial.